the universal big data story, and quandary. We can find this pattern everywhere. It does not matter where we look. We can see in computational fluid dynamics. Physicists and astronomers are facing these dilemmas. It's not possible to study all the stars and black holes physically. We see this pattern with marine biologists, biochemists, psychologists, sociologists, sports scientists, journalists, and those studying the humanities. We see this evolution with government councils, banks, call centers, retail websites, transportation. The list is virtually endless. You can experience this yourself as you collect your own photos. People like to collect things. This is another contributing factor to the data chaos. A person may not even have a goal to reach or a problem they are trying to solve. They just like to collect. The visual cortex. Data visualization uses computer graphics to generate images of complex data sets. It's different from computer graphics. Computer graphics is a branch of computer science, yes, but its appeal reaches far beyond that relatively specialized field. In its short lifetime, computer graphics has attracted some of the most creative people in the world to its fold, from the classic text course Introduction to Computer Graphics by Foley et al. Visualization tries to generate images of reality. Visualization exploits our powerful visual system. We have several billion neurons dedicated to our visual processing and visual cortex. See? Several billion neurons are devoted to analyzing visual information. The numbers of neurons are not very meaningful unless we put them into context. We have 8% of the cortex dedicated to touch and 3% dedicated to hearing. We have anywhere from 4 to 10 times of our cortex dedicated to visual processing than the other senses. It makes sense to explore the visual processing power in our brains as opposed to the other senses. It's dedicated to processing color, motion, texture, and shape. Visualization goals. Data visualization has some strengths and goals itself. One of the goals of data visualization is exploring data. This may be the case when the user does not know anything about their data set. They just want to find out what it looks like and its characteristics. Users search for trends or patterns in the data. Exploration is for the user that's not very familiar with the dataset. Visualization is also good for analysis, to confirm or refute a hypothesis. An expert may have collected the data for a special purpose and would like to confirm or refute a hypothesis or answer a specific question. Visualization is also effective for presentation. When our exploration and analysis is finished, we can present the results to a wider audience. Visualization is also good for acceleration, i.e. to speed up something such as a search process. This is often a decision-making process or knowledge discovery process. We can see things that were otherwise impossible.